all know that long-term eating of salty food raises our blood pressure, but how bad is it really? A raised blood pressure known as hypertension is the most common cardiovascular disease. The diagnosis of hypertension is based on repeated measurements of elevated blood pressure at 140 per 90 mm mercury. A survey carried out in 2009, 28% of the American adults showed hypertension. Experts recommend that people take in less than 2,500 milligrams of sodium a day. That is what's in about 6 grams of salt, or about a teaspoon. But right now, the average man in the United States takes in over 10 grams of salt per day, and the average woman takes in over 7 grams of salt per day. The salt we sprinkle on the food we eat actually accounts for less than 10% of our salt consumption. Most of the salt we eat comes in processed food from the stores, restaurants, and dining halls. Take for example a fast food franchise. The advantage of adding salt is to preserve the food for long-term usage and to make the customers more thirsty. Increased salt intake will increase the osmolarity in the bloodstream. This in turn activates osmoreceptors within the hypothalamus that tells your brain, hey, I'm thirsty. That is why a meal is consisting of a hamburger, a fries, and a drink. What a coincidence, right? So now we have a person with an increased blood pressure, and this sustained hypertension damages the blood vessel in the person's heart, kidney, and brain, which lead in turn to an increased incidence of coronary disease, renal failure, stroke, and dementia. But how does this really happen? Salt is all around us, whether it is in spicy nuts, chips, fries, fast foods, or even added salt to our everyday food. Salt is an essential to our body fluid. The chemical name of table salt is sodium chloride, which consists, as the name indicates, of the chemical elements sodium and chloride. Eating salt raises the amount of sodium in your bloodstream, and since sodium is an osmotically active substance, it will attract water to it. This leads to an increased volume and hence pressure inside of your arteries. To cope with the extra strain, the tiny muscles in the artery wall becomes stronger and thicker. Yet, this will only make the space inside the arteries smaller and raises your blood pressure even higher. The decreased space inside the artery will decrease the amount of blood reaching that organ that the blood vessel is supplying. Whether it happens in the artery supplying your kidney, then kidney failure will develop. If it happens in the artery supplying your heart, then heart attack will develop. If it happens in the artery supplying your brain, then stroke will develop. Since kidney is the major filtering organ that removes this excessive water, if it is damaged, then a vicious cycle will develop, in which a further increase in the blood volume due to the inability of the kidney to remove the excessive water build will develop. This in turn increases the blood pressure even higher. Treating hypertension involves a healthy lifestyle with reduced salt intake, regular exercise, quitting smoking, and avoiding excessive alcohol intake. Antihypertensive drugs such as diuretics is needed more in severe cases of hypertension. Many countries have already begun to tackle hypertension using various strategies, anywhere from working with industries to reduce the salt content in processed food to developing more efficient antihypertensive drugs. The United Kingdom, for example, has achieved a remarkable 10% reduction in the salt consumption over the past 4 years. But wouldn't we all miss the salty food taste? Well, several studies have shown that it is not easy, but as you gradually reduce the sodium intake, you lessen the desire for salty food, the same mechanism as for sugar craving. So in summary, the best take-home message from this video is that anything in this world in which you overdo or overconsume will be harmful to your body. In terms of advice, pay highly attention to the nutrition facts on the labels and try to select food with less than 5% of the daily value of salt per serving, because even a small reduction can have an effect on your blood pressure. I hope you all enjoyed this cartoon about hypertension and found this video useful. I will be uploading on this channel from now on medical cartoon videos that hopefully will simplify topics for you. And you are more than welcome to comment down below any suggestion of topics that might need to be clarified. If you like this video, please hit the thumbs up and subscribe to not miss any upcoming future videos.